Peace party people. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is Let the Record Show. I am Mike Pizzo.
I am Warren Peace.
And today's special guest, the Free Nationals. What's up, gentlemen?
How you guys doing?
Hey. So thank you. As I was saying earlier, thank you for all doing the show. We know the world's crazy right now with everything going on, but we appreciate you. We appreciate you being here.
No doubt, man.
Yeah, so you guys gave us a list of some of your favorite tracks of all time. And then we went and hunted down everything on vinyl. And now we're going to play those tracks and let the record show. All right, Kelsey, D'Angelo, Voodoo LP. And
Wow.
The Bible.
The Bible.
Yeah? Why is this the Bible?
Well, for musicians, man, like a lot of musicians wanted to play like that when they heard that record.
Yeah.
Everybody sound like that. Everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah. Every single song too, you know. Every.
I know. I did.
Yeah.
Yeah, little brother. We had little brother on the show. They picked this. Fonte picked this album.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what about this cut in particular, Kels?
I said Africa.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, the first time I ever heard that one was like way after I like my homie burnt me the CD, but left that one off. It was like the last song. And so I'd never had it. And I've like a couple years later, I was like, or maybe a year later, I was like, wait, what is this song? Like I never, you know, I was like, holy shit. I just came across the dopest thing ever. And I didn't even know. Yeah. And
that's crazy.
Something about all those songs when you're playing those songs, you feel, it's like a feeling.
Yeah.
Like listening to it is great too, but like when we're jamming along with those joints, especially that one,
yeah,
it's like meditation or something. Yeah. It's crazy.
Yeah, you know, the origin of this song, man, is Questlove and the band, when they were doing the jam sessions, they would just play like an entire artist's album. So they played Prince's Parade, like they played the whole thing. And then once they like got into that jam session, like the drums, they were like mimicking. Essentially, they ended up using it for this shit.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, so you can kind of hear that same like pattern with the drums.
Yeah, I had the same issue when I had a friend send me the CD. It was that song wouldn't fit on the last song, so I didn't hear that shit till way later.
Oh, what? What are the odds?
I was like, yo, what song is this? They're like, it's all Voodoo. I'm like, no, it ain't. I had a burnt CD.
Yeah, maybe this was like the CDs were too long. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, 60 minute ones.
Right. Exactly.
Probably. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. There it is, yeah. D'Angelo, Africa. All right, next up, Jose, we got Thundercat's Drunk LP. This is the 4-inch, the 10-inch box set.
Oh, I need that. Wow. Never seen it. That's badass.
Your cut is Them Changes. This is a banger.
Yeah.
And you guys actually, didn't you guys do like a live version of this? Is that right?
We played with him.
Yeah.
At something. Yeah. We did the pack house. We played it with him.
Yeah. How was that?
Fun, man. We play that song any chance we can, like, yeah. Sound check, like jam sessions, like, yeah.
Yeah, so tell us about it. How did you
turn it up a little bit, please?
Yeah, turn it up, please. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously a newer cut, but like tell us about it, man.
Basically I was like, you know, I was, you know, like everybody, you go through stuff with in relationships and stuff. And I don't know necessarily what he's talking about, like as far as if it's about, I think it has something to do with his family from the music video.
Yeah.
But for some reason, it kind of hit me on a relationship kind of thing.
Yeah.
But it had me all in my like feelings and stuff, man. I remember the first time I heard it, I was like all feeling all emotional and shit.
Yeah.
And I tweeted Thundercat. I was like, bro, thank you for this song, you know? And he hit me back. He was like, yeah, no doubt, man. I got you, you know? And I was like, but from there, man, this song is just special, man. He got the drums, the Isaac Brothers intro drums.
Yep.
It's classic Thundercat, you know, doing his thing and singing, and it's fire, bro. This song will be one of those songs people play like way down the line when I'm gone and my kids right. are still here.
100%.
Yeah.
How about the rest of the crew? I mean, I know some of you guys played on the live version.
He's one of our, you know, one of our closest good boys. We just tuned with him on this last summer.
Right.
That's just our friend, you know. So, but I mean, everything he does and everything, every time he plays, he's in another galaxy. He's just so far beyond all of us musically that he just, you know.
Yeah. Super creative. All right, there it is. Thundercat, shout out Thundercat.
Yeah. Yes, yeah.
All right, Caleb. Led Zeppelin 2. Whoa. Your cut on here is a whole lot of love. Let's check this out.
Nice.
This is like one of the best bass lines ever. Like this shit is so.
It's so amazing. So
tell us about this, man. What's your story here?
Shit, man. I was just like really into this. Like, it wasn't the first thing I got into. I kind of got into rap first when I was in elementary school.
Yeah.
But then, like, sixth, seventh grade, like middle school, like, we got heavy into like classic rock. This was, you know, this is a classic, you know?
Standard.
I don't know if it's my favorite song. I mean, it's just like, it just brings back memories kind of thing, you know?
Yeah.
It's more about that. Kind of developed my youth.
Anybody else in the group? Was this big for anyone?
Yeah, man. Jimmy Page, man.
Yeah.
Jimmy Page. Like, yeah, man, for sure. I listen to these records without a doubt.
Yeah.
You know, Black Dog and all that stuff. And
yeah.
Yeah, this joint. Yeah, huh? Jimmy Page was a beat.
What movie did they play this in? I remember hearing this in the movie. I just remember hearing this in the movie. I didn't really know it until I heard it in the movie. I can't remember which movie.
Probably in a lot of movies.
Yeah, that's
one of those songs that you just you hear it like in everything, commercials, it's, movies.
Yeah, yeah.
It's when the hero is about to go get the bad guy and they it's like that's every scene right there.
Yeah,
yeah.
Probably yeah, definitely classic cut. All right, there it is. Led Zeppelin, a whole lot of love. Ain't nothing but against the party. All right, Ron, on your list. Tupac, All Eyes on Me.
There we go.
All Eyes on Me?
Yeah.
Yeah. And,
damn. America's Most Wanted.
How we liked it.
How does it feel?
This one, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's you've been doing some like some tributes to Pac at your live show, Ron.
Say that again.
I said you've been doing some tributes, some live tributes.
Yeah, you know, doing the talk box, you got Roger Troutman. He did California Love. I like to do that on the show.
Yeah.
This joint right here, I love this. It's a nice party song right here. This one that I heard, you know, much later for sure.
Yeah.
And it's just cool. I love the groove. Dad, shout out to Daz Dillinger. He did this beat. I got to work with Snoop later on and found out he was producing all these joints. And this happened to be one of my favorite songs back then.
Nice. Yeah.
So Rod, how were you listening to all this stuff when you were listening mostly to Kurt Franklin?
I heard bits and pieces of it. Like, I'll go, like, my pretty much, like, my father's side, we listened to a lot of gospel and a lot of jazz and a lot of, you know, real old school stuff. But then my grandmother, my mother's side, my uncle, he would be playing Snoop and playing Dre. I would hear bits and pieces. And I remember him playing, actually, Doggy Style album. I remember hearing him playing Tupac, a lot of Tupac. And this is one that stuck out to me.
You snuck it? You snuck it? You had to sneak
it? I snuck it, yeah, to sneak. Well, later on, once I got a little older, I was like, man, I started listening to other stuff. And I'm like, yeah, and I go do my research. And certain songs stuck out to me. I snuck it in there. You got to sneak it in sometime. Get it in where you can.
Wow.
He snuck it.
And Kelsey, you said you were big into Pac at that time too, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it was like a lot of Dre to DJ Quick.
Yeah.
A lot of DJ Quick. I mean, that was like, you know, that was everything.
Yeah.
But yeah, Pac was like the first, one of the first songs I ever memorized, like a rap song, was Pain off the Above the Rim soundtrack.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah.
I think Warren's got a plaque for Above the Rim behind him.
Yeah, I got it.
Crazy.
Yeah. All right. It is Tupac, two of America's most wanted. All right, Kels, another one from your set, Blue Gas.
Oh, you found that?
Shadows from Nowhere. Yeah,
yo! Blue vinyl, too. I need that.
Yeah, on blue vinyl. All
right, I might send it to you, man.
That's insane.
I don't know anything about this.
I tried to do as much research as I could, but it was like, it's so hard to find. I've only found two guys that were like a part of it, and I found like their other bands that they were in and stuff, and have to hear that stuff. But really, I don't really know much. It's like two cats from Italy did the song.
What
1983 or something?
Yeah, 84.
84, I mean, yeah.
How'd you find it? Like,
yeah.
I think I was just going on YouTube one day. You just like go click on a cool cover and then you listen to it and then you're like, oh, this is cool. And then you see a bunch of other covers. That one I found like that, just YouTube.
Yeah.
But, and it just stuck out in your head from that point on. You're like, yo, this song is the shit.
Yeah. The bass line was the craziest bass line. Like, he's doing like harmonics and bends. And it's like a crazy, like, I've tried to play along with the song. It's just like so subtle and just so genius. I don't know. There's a part in there where the drums come in out of nowhere and some like crazy synths.
Yeah.
And it just like, it's like four bars of that and then it just goes away. And then you're like, what? It's a great song.
It reminds me a lot of that 07 and Air and that kind of thing. You know, down tempo, you know, but this is 84 and those groups are early 2000s. Yeah, yeah. So, and kind of similar to Bee Gees.
It got me into like trying to listen to more Italian shit like this.
Cause
I'm sure they were on something, you know? Like,
what other Italian stuff?
I don't know the names off the top. I mean, really, it was just that dude. I forget his name.
Celso Valley.
Yeah, yeah, that dude.
The producer, yeah.
He was in another band called like Mantra or something like that.
Yeah.
I think Mantra. And they have like, they only have like two or four songs or some shit. But yeah, it's like, yeah, when we went to Italy on this last tour and I just like went crazy in the section just buying vinyls of just like cheap shit that just looked cool. From the same time period,
right?
There's some fire in there for sure.
Yeah,
I don't remember
the names though.
All right, there it is, Blue Gas, Shadows from Nowhere. All right, Ron's making guacamole.
My man is making guacamole right now, and, for real.
So while he does that. That's the nice thing about Zoom interviews. You can just be like, "Yeah, I'm gonna, you know, make some guacamole right now."
Yeah.
So, all right.
Whack.
Next up, Jose, we got Stevie Wonder Inner Visions LP.
Whoa.
Golden Lady.
Yeah, man.
Tell us about this, man.
Well, the first time I heard this song, I was driving on the 110 headed north, and the sun was coming down.
Yeah.
And I remember feeling like kind of like high from hearing this. And it was like, I was like, music can make you feel high even when you're not. You know what I mean? Like a song like this, I was just like, it made me feel a certain type of way. And it was a good thing, you know?
Yeah.
And it was like, for music to be able to do that to you without any kind of substance or anything, I thought that was special. So
100%.
And then this whole record is just a classic record, man. It's the songs out here are timeless. And Stevie Wonder is one of the greatest of all time. He's still with us, so we gotta protect him while he's here.
Yeah, it's true, man. Like, you know, we gotta give him his flowers now, you know what I mean? Like, you think about the people that we lost, like Prince, like David Bowie, you know.
Yep.
You know, it's just great to have a legend like Stevie still with us. Ron, tell us about it, man.
Yeah, hey, tell us about the chord progression.
Hey, Ron, tell us about the chord progression.
This is Golden Lady?
Yeah.
He's crazy. He goes to the fire. And he goes.
And this is G minor.
Yep.
Going down from that.
Up to A flat major.
Major. Okay, guys, for all you students out there.
Yeah.
Like some Latin salsa and shit, you know?
It's like salsa. Yeah, it's like that chromatic progression is like a Spanish type of sound. Like,
And it doesn't sound like a Spanish. It sounds like soulful or something. It doesn't sound.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's that move, that little move right there. So it has
going up. It has to every the end when it keeps going up.
Yeah. That right there. I had never heard that before in the music. Like I was like, I would always hear songs just end, you know, and then he up.
I was like, you know, it's a good song, man. You can just keep going.
The key bass. I love the key bass.
Yeah.
Killing the key bass.
He kind of used that same technique on Don't You Worry About a Thing.
You
know what I mean? Like at the end, the same kind of, you know.
He was getting all these new synths back then when they were coming out, and he was just being like super innovative with it.
Yeah.
Songwriting wise, man, this is like a lesson for everybody. Like anybody trying to write.
Just amazing, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, there it is, Stevie Wonder.
Stevie Wonder.
Double salute.
All right, Caleb, we got Ramones, Havana.
The Ramones.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Is it clear all the way through?
Yeah.
It's a red vinyl, yeah. That was just the sleeve, but...
Yeah, tell us about this, man.
The Ramones. Shit. What can be said that hasn't already been said, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know, so it's the same thing. Like, middle school, just like childhood, like... I wore the shit out of this album when I was real young, skateboarding around, you know, with my friends. Brings back a lot of good memories. A lot of chips, a lot of memories, a lot of skateboarding. Yeah. Yeah.
And how about
and their musicianship too is like probably above Stevie Wonder, but it's still like, you know, they can respect it too, like Stevie fans.
No, I mean, but like I was saying that before, first of all, the camaraderie you guys is like insanely good, but like just the musicality of you, like it's all you're pulling from different places. Like I would love to hear be in a studio with you guys and Caleb does a drum or plays a song and then Ron goes, what the hell is that? You know? And Jose's like, that shit ain't working. You know, like I can just feel you guys just like, nah, we're not good with that. Oh, whatever. But, you know, the Ramones out of everyone on this list, like that's a very far left or right cut. Like, so, but you know, together it makes sense.
It does.
Yeah.
A little bit of a raw element to the group, you know?
Yeah.
We're not straight up just, you know, pure schoolyard funk.
Yeah.
Were you a lot more rock influence growing up or hip hop?
Well, I mean, I liked everything growing up, but like when we were like, my dad always listened to like, you know, jazz and fusion, but when I was playing in bands and stuff, it was always like rock, punk.
Okay.
Growing up, you know, we played funk a lot too, but there's definitely a lot of rock, you know?
Right. Okay.
Did you,
in hip hop too.
Did you ever peep the Red Hot Chili Peppers version of this track?
Oh yeah, I have. Oh yeah.
So he's got a surprise cut.
So so this is basically it's got the Ramones on one side and Chili Peppers on the B side. Here's the Chili Peppers version. So
here's the Chili Peppers version.
Did this you feel like they did it justice?
It's pretty good. Yeah. I mean, it sounds. I mean, I don't know. I'm not gonna comment. It's they did
the cover. Yeah. You know,
I haven't heard it in honestly a long time, but
yeah,
definitely put the Chili Peppers twist
kind of
on it.
No, totally. But they should have. Here's one thing I'm not the biggest fan of: is when bands like cover a song and they like completely change it. Sometimes that's cool, but most of the time I just want to hear like them do it how they do it. You know?
Yeah, yeah. I'll tell you an interesting story. When you guys did. It was like around when David Bowie died, you guys played Just Dance.
Yeah.
And you guys were playing at Mandalay Bay with Anderson. Yeah. And I went and saw you guys, and the same night Duran Duran was playing like in the concert hall in the same building.
Yeah.
So you guys were at House of Blues. So like I watched your show, and then I ran to the Mandalay Bay Event Center to see Duran Duran. And as I'm walking in, they're playing David Bowie's Space Oddity.
Oh.
And I was like, this is crazy. Like, these two bands are essentially paying tribute to Bowie at the same exact time. Pretty amazing.
Yeah. We did that. Like, never randomly on TV, we did that cut backstage. Yeah. we just landed quick and like I was DJing at that time, so like I made some quick edit to like go. It went from one song, didn't it, to drop right into the Bowie thing.
It was at the end of Am I Wrong?
Yeah, and yeah, Am I Wrong? Yeah, we
damn
turned out cool.
We didn't even rehearse that at all.
No,
wow,
amazing. All right, there it is.
Ramones, all right, cool.
Red Hot Chili Peppers, Havana Affair. All right, Kelsey, next up on your list, El Chicano.
Hell yeah.
Shout out to Double P's who hooked this copy up of the record. But yeah, man, tell us about this. I know, go ahead.
Yeah, just like my my family, it's like my grandma's favorite song. My dad always jamming it. There's like, it's an old song. This is just their version of it, but this is like the lowrider.
Right. Lowrider version.
Yeah, I don't know. This is just like, one of my favorite chord progressions. The singing, everything about it just feels good, you know?
Yeah, super, super chill cut. And Kali Uchis did a cover, who you guys just worked with on your album. Yeah. What else can you tell me about this track? Was this were you hearing this a lot growing up, or?
Yeah. My grandma would always sing it, like on her birthday. Like that was like so one time she had a mariachi band and they like sang that song to her. But that's just always her jam. So
yeah.
So it's kind of like she's kind of like losing her memory these days. So like my dad will go over there and visit her all the time and go play guitar and songs and stuff. Cause he's been a mariachi for like 15 years now. So he's like. He was a professor at Cal State LA teaching like theater and playwriting stuff, and then he took classes to be a mariachi and was in the program as a teacher. I mean, as a student, but you know, still a teacher at the school. So he was in wearing the full blown like outfit, doing like recitals and shit, like you know, like college student. But he's like an old dude, so like.
No.
He's it was cool because he learned how to do that after I already knew how to play. So it was like watching my dad learn something I already knew. It's kind of crazy. And he would have to be in there going so hard. Like you have to play super loud and sing really fucking loud, you know, like that's like the whole thing. So like, I just remember when he was first learning, me and my mom were just like, whoa, it was so loud, but you know. Like the whole thing, you know, and now he's ripping. He went from like every instrument too. He like went from the guitar to the you know, the vihuela, the regular guitar, trumpet, and now he's on violin. He's just trying to learn everything just a little bit. You know?
Nice.
I love it. It's incredible.
Props to your dad for real for that one.
Props.
All right, there it is. Sabor Ami. All right, Ron, you're up.
Oh, that was bad.
All right, Ron. All right, put the avocados down.
He's up.
All right, Ron. We got Herbie Hancock. Feats Don't Fail Me Now LP.
Feats Don't Fail Me Now.
So basically, I first heard this song from Sarah. Sarah. This song,
yeah,
it's called Vampire Van. Was it Fantastic Vampire?
I don't know. I don't know.
Yeah, Vampire. But we were playing with him back.
Fantastic Vampire.
Yeah, Fantastic. There you go. And it's featuring Erykah Badu and Herbie Hancock. I was just like, yo, the song was hard back then. The way they cut it up, and we used to play with them live. And then I found out it was an old school Herbie Hancock joint. And it's been one of my favorite songs ever since. Yeah, the chord changes, just the lyrics on the song. He's using a vocoder, and this is a big one for me.
You know what's crazy, man, is that like this is 1979, and Herbie was 27 albums in. he had 27 albums.
Wow.
I'm like, damn. You know, like people aren't prolific like that anymore.
No.
You know what I mean?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn. He's a genius.
How about the vocoder? Yeah, I mean, like, he's using a vocoder here. Like, obviously, that's so common now with auto-tune and everything.
Yeah.
But
let's clarify the difference with the vocoder and auto-tune. Nava, how many people think that they use an auto-tune?
They all call it auto-tune, no matter what it is.
Right.
Auto-tune is taking over the name. How's it different?
Yeah, how's it different?
The vocoder is a keyboard. It's basically a keyboard sound that you create the sound with your mouth.
Right.
Then you got the talk box, which has the amp and the tube. The sound goes into your mouth and you mouth the words. So that's different. You're actually, that's like a whole nother beast right there. The auto-tune is just something, it's a plug-in.
Button.
Yeah, you put the key in and then you just sing. You just go ahead and talk or sing whatever you want.
Yeah.
And it's good. So.
And what do you use on your live performances when you, I know you incorporate some of that, right?
I use the vocoder and the talk box.
Okay.
So, rolling joint, old school rolling joint. Herbie used to use that one.
Yeah.
And then I use a talk box. Yeah. Talk Star. Shout out to Talk Star.
Okay. There it is. And
Jose,
you don't even have to air guitar. You can just produce a real guitar. hold on. I got a real guitar right here. I'm just... All right. There it is. Herbie Hancock. Trust me.
Word.
Yeah. That whole album is dope too, you know? But that's one of my favorite ones.
All right, Jose.
Oh, wow.
With the Miles Davis quintet.
There you go, Jose.
Yo, man.
Got me. Hey, can you turn this one up so I can hear it?
Yeah, turn this one up.
This one always makes me cry.
Dude.
He's going to cry?
It never entered my mind. This song's beautiful, man. Like, it's... Try to hold it together. It's... It hasn't even started yet. Okay, there it goes. Yeah, this is a beautiful song, man. I mean, you could put this in... It's like... It sounds like a... romantic movie with a sad ending scene and the rain's coming down, and I mean, tell us about it, man.
I heard, okay, so I recently heard this song because I was watching that Miles Davis documentary that
came out.
And they were like showing a part of his life, and this song came on and I had to go look it up, man. And I was just like, man, this is incredible. It's just like, so it's the tempo slow. A lot of people don't do like slow tempo stuff. And he's singing, man. He's like singing with his trumpet and
sick,
crazy, crazy song.
Just a beautiful song, man.
Yeah, man. Yeah. It's like to be able to play like this, finesse a song like this. It takes a lot of talent, man. Mm-hmm. Like this is crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like this song is crazy, man. There's like this is pretty typical for jazz back then, but there's like over 30 different covers of this track, but this is by far.
Right.
The most superior version. I mean, it's just that trumpet.
Who wrote it originally? Like, do you know? Or is it
Shirley Ross?
Oh,
it was like from a musical called Higher and Higher.
Oh, that's what it is. All right, I didn't know
and
that.
So, crazy. Yeah, like Sinatra, like Stan,
Ella Fitzgerald.
Hey, yeah.
They've all covered it.
Yeah, but this
Weird Al covered it too.
Yeah,
but Jose, you picked the best copy.
Yeah.
Miles, rest in peace, man. What a genius. What a psycho at the same time.
He just had a birthday the other day.
He did? Happy birthday, Miles.
Yeah.
All right. Guacamole man in the back.
All right. Yeah. There it is. Miles Davis.
Miles Davis. A lot of people don't know this, but he really liked guacamole.
You did.
I read that on his Wikipedia.
Yeah.
I'm going to edit the wiki right now. All right, Miles Davis, it never entered my mind. Caleb and Jose, too, you guys both came with it.
Whoa.
With
Weird Al.
Yankovic's greatest hits, which includes, it doesn't have Amish Paradise, which is, I think, what the initial request was.
Yeah.
But, it does include Fat and Eat It, so.
Fucking fans, y'all.
What?
These are my first two CDs I ever bought.
What?
Okay, so Caleb, you're the one who gave us an entire list of Weird Al songs.
Well, yeah, this is pretty much the inspiration for like the whole band and everything we've done.
Uh huh.
Just
the main
all Weird Al. Just he was, I don't know, he's just funny. I thought he was a comedian, but apparently he does music too, so.
Yeah.
He just got.
Did you appreciate his musicality? I mean, like, you and Kelsey, no. Like, you have the CD. Like, are you guys like, his boldness, his punk rock? There we go. You produce.
Yeah.
His punk rock. That's what you liked about it.
The main thing I liked is when, like, he tried to apologize to Coolio, and then, like, Coolio still wanted nothing to do with him. Didn't something happen like that?
Yeah.
No, but he's pretty bold, but, he's kind of just like a complete psychopath, I think, right?
Yeah.
He's a legend.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
he's,
yeah.
I mean, like, this is... I always wondered, like, if he asked permission for the artist to do the covers.
Don't get it twisted. I used to listen to that.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's punk rock. Like, he doesn't even ask. He just does it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. All of his money like that. That's badass.
What was it, Ron?
Yeah.
Yeah, Weird Al was the man. When I was listening to Kirk Franklin, I heard a lot of Weird Al songs.
Yeah, it's like that time.
Yeah.
Wow.
Everyone listened to Weird Al a little bit back then, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, remember he used to do the polka, like, medleys? Like, he'd do, like, a 16-minute, like, polka, like, and he would play, like, every hot song of the moment.
Yeah.
There it is.
Look at that. Look at that.
I can't believe you produced a Weird Al, two Weird Al CDs, like, yeah,
just
like that. Yeah. All right. You got the cilantro. Come on.
Yeah,
now.
You gotta have the cilantro.
Gotta have the cilantro. All right, there it is, Weird Al Yankovic, the greatest hits. All right, Ron. One more for you is it's right here.
Which one is that?
Tell us about it. Just knee deep.
This is funky too, right here. I first heard this song on the movie Good Burger. When they went, actually, first version of the song I heard was Daylight Soul, Me, Myself, and I.
Yes.
My dad had the cassette tape, and I used to listen to it every day. Like,
I love it.
You know, with something about it. And then I got older, and a big Good Burger came out. Mm-hmm. And then they played this version when they were in the psychopath place. And I was like, what is this? It's not De La Soul. And then I've looked ever since.
That's great.
Yeah, have you gone back and listened to more Parliament or even George solo? Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
I think I listened to a few of their songs, but I didn't know knee deep.
How many times have you been on the West Coast? How many times have you, like, listened to it? Because I actually did the same thing, going back and listen to Old Parliament and realize that, like, you hear, like, every Ice Cube album, every like DJ Snoop. Quick. Like, how many times did that happen for you? Like
all the time.
Yeah.
I hear it now. I'm like, oh yeah, this is that joint. Okay.
Yeah.
With everything. Yeah. It's my favorite songs ever. What's I would play this all the time. So funky.
Del picked this. Del the Funky Homo Sapien picked this when we had him on the show.
Yeah.
So shout out Del. Alright, here it is.
George Quinn.
Alright, cool.
Funkadelic, DD.
Peace and love, man.
Alright, finally we have the album, The Free Nationals.
Dope.
Which is, you got some nice looking vinyl here. You got the gold version, Caleb's got the gold version. And Jose and Kels, and you got the Urban Outfitters like splatter vinyl, and then I don't know which one you have, Ron, but I got the single.
Oh,
so, you know, yeah,
this
yeah,
is the record
yeah.
store. Wow. The single. That's what we're gonna play. But
I got nothing.
I ain't got shit.
I got nothing.
Yeah.
Can we kick him out?
I'm gonna go make some guacamole.
What's the story? Where can people get the album on vinyl right now?
You can get it online, I think, right? It's like all the pre-orders sold out, but there's like
Empire.
It's on our Instagram link. You can check it out. It'll be on there.
And then the Urban Outfitters has the splatter vinyl.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. So what? I mean. You know, this is culmination of you guys worked on Anderson Paak's records, you know, first couple records, but now you have your
is that on the wrong speed?
Is it?
It's not half speed.
nice.
There you go. Yeah, yeah.
There we go.
Yeah. I like that.
Yeah, chopped, I knew Kelsey's like, yo, I like this version.
Chopped and screwed version. Yeah.
The screwed and chopped version.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, yeah, tell us about this record, what you guys are trying to accomplish. Yeah. Did you feel like you met your goals in terms of what kind of music you wanted to make for a group album?
For sure, I think, right? I mean, it was fun. We kind of just did it over the course of kind of a while, just being on tour. But yeah, it was all self-produced. We did it like in our place and sent it out, got the features. I don't know. I was pretty happy with it. What'd you guys think? Josh?
It was dope.
I had a great time, and making it. It was like he said, we did it pretty quick, but then, you know, just sat on it for a minute and got the features. We didn't rush it. We just took our time and made something dope.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was like quick, but it wasn't. It was like stretched out.
Yeah.
But the next one will be the next one. Oh my God, you gotta get the next one.
Weird Al.
You got Weird Al on your next album?
You didn't hear it from me, but that's the rumor right now. We got Weird Al on the album.
Yeah. So, and Kels, what did you want to say about the record?
Yeah, it was so fun to make. It was just like old school album style. Like, we just, you know, a lot of it, we got in there as a band, everyone on their instruments, and like jammed the songs out. We made A section, B section, you know, really tried to write, like, you know, good little tunes. It's fun.
Yeah, so tell us about, just for the people that don't know, you got a pretty solid guest list on there.
Oh yeah.
Who's on the record?
Daniel Caesar, Cal Uchis, Mac Miller.
Yep, rest in peace.
West Side Gun and Conway, Sid, Benny Sings.
Yeah.
Another orchestra. Chronix.
Anderson Paak.
Yeah.
Adia.
T.I.
Damn.
Shout out to Adrian on now.
Halo.
Jose, tell us about the record. I mean, like, everybody else kind of weighed in.
It's a pile of shit, and I don't recommend listening to it. No, I'm kidding. No, it's incredible, man. I'm proud of it. These are my boys. We did it together as a unit, and through unity, there's some special things that come from that.
Yeah.
I feel really, I'm proud of it, man. The presentation, the sound.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great, and when everything, you know, when everything comes back and we can start playing shows again, we're going to go on tour for it, man. Do what we got to do.
Okay. Word.
Word up. All right.
I'll be in the front row with chips and guacamole hanging out. Yeah.
Everybody, go get the Free Nationals album.
Definitely.
And, looks like the gold vinyl sold out. You probably find it on Discogs. And sounds like Urban Outfitters has the splatter.
Yeah.
The splatter, which I'm a track down right after we get
splatter.
On. Yeah. All right, that is it. This is Let the Record Show. I am Mike Pizzo.
I am Warren Peace.
And today's special guest, the Free Nationals. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Yeah. Everybody, amen. Go get that Free Nationals album.
No justice, no peace.
100%.
There you go.
100%. Exactly. Yep. All right. Peace.
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 Peace. Peace.